Imagine if the Ian Malcolm prophecy from the first movie had actually come true. What if the Pirates of the Caribbean, right, had actually broken down and started eating people? I mean, you know, the Tiki Tiki Room is a bloodbath. Tinkerbell and the rest of Pixie Hollow, they're lending air support. Fantasyland is just a kill box. I'm gonna say it now before we even get into it. The carnivores are a bunch of assholes and are completely ruining it for the herbivores. In any of those four previous movies, the herbivores have never been to blame for one single loss of human life. And yet, they're always sort of like grouped in with the rest of these fucking asshole carnivores that just can't understand, like, no, no, that's a human. Don't eat the effing human. And of course, you don't understand what I'm saying to you because your brain is literally the size of a walnut, you stupid, stupid animal with ridiculously large teeth and claws. I can't even argue with you right now because you're gonna eat my face off. Fuck you. I don't have too much to add. Let's go ahead and check this shit out, shall we? And play.
So, what are you dating, like an accountant now? Or
Owen.
Ventriloquist?
Stop it.
You love a dummy.
This is not
what I'm here. You can blame me. So I guess they didn't go on that second date.
Try to shame me.
Not the monorail.
Oh, rescue op. Save the dinosaurs from an island that's about to explode.
Oh, that's why it's exploding.
Blue is alive. You raised her.
Baby raptor. That's a horrifying sound.
Do these animals deserve the same protections given to other species?
Yes.
Or should they just be left to die?
These creatures were here before us.
I love you.
I love you!
Careful. And they'll be here after.
Blue!
You know me.
She's gonna eat your face off. Told you.
Life cannot be contained. Life breaks free.
Tracy.
Life finds a way.
Shit, that was a bummer. Oh my god. Wait a minute. So, okay, this is the moment when I really need my buddy Joel Heller here. And I'm, you know what? Let's.
Your call has been
forwarded
to an automated voicemail.
Stop.
Hey, what's up?
Hi, do you have a second?
I'm at a concert. What's up?
Oh, damn it. Okay, well, I had a Jurassic Park question, but I guess it can wait.
No, go ahead and ask. I'm already out. I walked out, so you're
okay. The island, that's Isla Nublar, right?
Yes.
Okay. Was it always built on top of a volcano?
No. I mean, it's a volcanic chain of islands, but they never specifically said Isla Nublar was
An active volcano. Okay.
Yes.
Stop. I'm talking with your uncle. Shush. So that's just a new thing for the movie, I suppose.
I'm guessing. I'm wondering if it's actually a volcano or if it's something that was like planted on the island.
I thought that too. Yeah. Is that like a failsafe or something?
That's what I'm thinking. Like the lysine contingency. Remember that from the first one that they had?
I do remember that. Yes.
So I'm wondering if that's a failsafe that when they built the park. As a last resort, hey, let's build this into the mountain where we have this complex and just blow the hell out of it if we need to.
See, yeah, that would make a lot more sense to me than just this, like, hey, remember that theme park we built right on top of a...
active volcano.
Yeah. Hey, get here, Spock. Sorry, he's yelling at me. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't realize you were at a concert. I'm going to let you go. Call me after, because...
Is everything okay with you out in LA with the fires?
Yeah, they're nowhere near us. We're totally fine. Speaking of everything being on fire, yeah, no, we're good for now. So, yeah.
All right.
Thank you. Okay, bye. Okay, so we got some answers there. That was my buddy Joel, who is like the hugest Jurassic Park fan you're ever going to find ever. Okay, he's such a huge fan that we actually spent one of his birthdays at Dino World. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you should really look that up because that is a treasure. I'm willing to bet on his theory. I do like that spin that they are actively there trying to save the dinosaurs. That is the aspect about the Jurassic Park movies that I kind of think about the most. We as human beings are so obtrusive to the natural order. At what point do we step in or remove ourselves completely? Yeah, the trailer itself, yeah, a bit of a downer, but I kind of like that. This looks awesome. I'm really, really optimistic about it. Big shout out to my friend Joel, who came through in the clutch. So sorry that I ruined your concert going experience, bud. But for the rest of you, please let me know what you think. Like, comment below, subscribe, do whatever it is that you feel the need to do, and I will talk to you later. Okay, love you, bye.